Sairam. Prashanti Nilayam in the town of Puttaparthi today is a pilgrimage place for millions of devotees around the world. But do you know how this town got the name Puttaparthi? Today we will go through the amazing legend and a lovely leela of our Lord associated with it that actually gave this town the name Puttaparthi. I am walking through the town of Puttaparthi, which famously had been described once upon a time as being a stone's throw from Stone Age. That was how God forsaken it was in those days. But the reality and truth is that it wasn't as God forsaken as people thought it to be. And this is the legend of Gollapalli, the legend of Puttaparthi, how the village, the town got its name. It all begins at this temple, the Sri Venugopala Swami Temple. In those days, Puttaparthi was called Gollapalli, meaning the village of cows. And the reason is not hard to comprehend, because this village was filled with cows. It was like the Nanda Gokula of Krishna's times, Vrindavana. There was a lot of curds, milk, butter, ghee flowing everywhere in the village until one fateful day. One of the cowherds in the village noticed that his favorite cow was not yielding any milk. He noticed that this cow every evening would set out on its own and go to a very secluded spot. He began to follow this cow, and what he saw actually took his breath away. This cow was separating itself from the herd and going towards an anthill. From the anthill emerged a cobra, which began to suck milk from the udders of the cow. And when this happened, the cowherd got alarmed. He got shocked. He was angry that this snake is drinking away the milk that belongs to him. And so he picked up a stone. The only thing is, it was not such a small stone, it was such a big boulder almost, and threw it at the snake, immediately killing it. Things changed dramatically after that day. The cows in the village of Gollapalli began to go dry and began to die out. All over the village, anthills sprang up. In Sanskrit, the term to denote anthill is Valmikam, and therefore Gollapalli was now called Valmikapuram. You know, Valmiki, the sage who wrote the Ramayana, is also named because of this Valmikam. It is said that when he was lost in meditation, an anthill formed around him, and that is why he began to be called Valmiki. And then the anthills grew so many in number that it began to be called Puttavardini. In Telugu, Putta means anthill. Puttavardini means the village where anthills flourish and progress. That Puttavardini got shortened to Puttaparthi. The people of the village got scared. They felt very sad that this episode had happened, and therefore they began to revere and in fact worship that stone with which the cowherd had killed the snake. They prayed to it as their Lord Krishna, their Lord Venugopala Swami, and that is how this Venugopala Swami temple has come into existence. When you visit Puttaparthi, make sure that you visit this beautiful temple, which has got everything amazing about it. It has still got the old world feel about it. It will be indeed an amazing experience. And to this day, the name Puttaparthi has stuck and it has stayed. Many years later, Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba, our dear Swami, revealed to the people a very amazing feature on that rock which the cowherd had used to kill the snake. He told them to wash the rock and apply turmeric and kumkum on it. And when that was done, people were amazed with wonderment, and they observed that the beautiful form of Lord Krishna leaning on a cow and playing the flute was seen. They were so thrilled that what they considered as their Venugopala Swami was indeed their Lord Venugopala Swami. A cobra drinking from the udders of a cow on its own without the cow dying and the cow giving milk on its own, this is an amazing miracle. Now, but because this cowherd was selfish and he was thinking only about his gain, which actually comes because of ego, he wasn't able to see this miracle. He saw it as something that made him angry, and he did something the reaction of which resulted in a curse almost for the entire place. That is what happens. Let us let go of this ego. That is the ultimate objective of Puttaparthi, to put apart the I. Thank you, Sai Ram.